from Diabetic Foot Care India Private Limited, Chennai. Now I will be describing about the kit content for the product Digital Biothesimeter Vibro Test LX. It's a very basic model. This is a carry bag, it's a padded bag, and then the instruments are kept inside. You will have a detailed user manual, and there are two numbers of spare fuses, the main biothesimetry unit, a mains cable for connecting with 230 volt mains. It does not have battery, it will operate only on mains, and then the vibrator probe. So this is connected to the instrument for testing on the patients. So this is the content. Now I will explain in detail about each and every parts, how to operate in few minutes. We are talking about digital biothesimeter Vibro Test LX. So this is the main unit. So I have removed the packing. So this is the main unit, and we have the probe, and then the mains cable. Okay. So this particular model is a basic model. Very few controls, easy to operate. You have a control here. It's called volt. It is for increasing the intensity of the vibration. Okay, clockwise rotation will increase, anti-clockwise rotation will reduce the intensity. You have an on-off switch, and you have a connector for connecting the vibration probe. Okay, just connect it here. Just tie the nut. Do not over tight it, just gently tight it. We have connected this mains cable. So on the back side, you have a socket for connecting the power cable. Okay, and you can see on the bottom there is, it's indicated actually, fuse. So there is a fuses, standby fuses, and the main fuse inside. Using a screwdriver, you can take it out, and then if the fuse is gone, we can replace it actually. Normally it will not happen, so we just connect the mains cable. Now I connected the mains cable, and then the other end of the mains cable I connected to the power cord. Now it's ready, so I switch it on. You can see it says DFC, Diabetic Foot Care, and then it shows 00. Always before starting the machine, we should see that this knob is in the fully counterclockwise direction. It should show 00. Okay, for this will help the machine to run for longer duration. So as you slowly increase, you can see the numbers are keep increasing actually, and you will also get a vibration here on the tip, which is proportional to this number. This is indicated as volts. Okay, you have a range of between 0 and 50 volts. Okay, when it reaches on the 50, we give a small alarm indicating that you are on the higher side. Okay, that's the maximum. Okay. So you need to increase it till patient gets the vibration. Where to test? The points are predefined. You can see here. The points is here, okay. Left foot and right foot, great toe, first metatarsal head, third metatarsal head, fifth metatarsal head, instep and heel. So 6 points per foot, totally 12 points you have to test. On this side, if you see, there are two keys. It's called record and check. Okay, record is for moving the data to computer, but that is not available in this particular model because this is a probe which is common for all the models. So this record key is not functional for this particular model because we don't have computer connectivity and we don't have the software for this. Okay. So check, when you press check, here the number, assuming okay you are keeping it at 15, patient says he's feeling the vibration. I press it, and now when I press, the vibration at the tip is stopped. And when you are asking the patient again, he should respond that he is not getting any vibration. When you release it, patient should say, I am feeling the vibration. So if so, that means what he is perceiving is correct. Suppose even when you press check, when you are stopping the vibration, and when the patient says, I am feeling it, probably that could be the touch sense, not the vibration sense. So you have to always put it on the patient hand, palm, on a bony area, and show them the vibration pattern, and you can increase them and decrease them so that they will understand how the vibration will feel like. Then when you test it on the foot, they can easily find it out, the difference. So once the patient says, I am getting it, assuming here at some 16, I press check, so patient would say, I am not feeling it. When I release, patient say, yes, I am getting. So that means the number is correct. Okay. Otherwise, you can keep increasing it till he gets the number. Okay. So in by and large, most of the clients agree that when the voltage is more than 25, that means okay, the patient foot is high. It is classified as high foot. High risk foot. So beyond 25, that means they lost the sensation, so they are likely to get injury, that leads to complications like amputations. So, but there are few clients, they classify up to 15, okay, they say it's normal. If you feel the vibration till 15, you are normal. Okay, when beyond 15 to 20, if you feel that, then you are mild loss of vibration perception. From 21 to 25, if you feel it, then you are classified as moderate, and beyond 25, severe or abnormal. Okay. So, but in any case, beyond 25 volt is considered abnormal. It's a very simple test. Okay. Once you complete the test, after finishing everything, you have to reduce it to zero again, and then you have to switch it off. That's it. Very simple to operate. This is the simplest product available with us. It's called Vibro Test ALX.
We have already discussed about Vibro Test ALX, our digital bioenergometer, about their controls, about their operation, the interpretation, how to use it on the patients, everything we have discussed. But unfortunately, that particular model does not have any documentary output for giving it as a report to the patient. So we need to prepare a pre-printed reporting format. So we are going to discuss about it. So you are seeing on the screen a few sample reports generated by our higher-end machines. Through computer, you can connect and then take the recording. You can use the same format. Instead of our name, you can print the hospital name and address with the logo. The ID, name, age, everything can be there without the names. You can make it blank. And the same way, within the foot, you have the values, so we can make it a blank form there, so that as you test, you can write the value inside. And then next, the average and the interpretation, that we can make it blank. So we can manually take the average, and then under the remarks column, then you can type or write the interpretations, whether it is normal, mild, moderate. If you see that there are two reports, the first one on the left side is mostly used in India. The one on the right side being used by our European clients. So in both, you can have the same setup. You can have And in case if you need any support from us, we can provide you the image, or if you want, we can even design the format. If you can furnish all your details, we can send you a blank design that you can give it to your printer, and then you can print it so that you can give it to the patient as a report. You can print it in a 50s or 100s booklet, and then you can give it to them actually. So this completes the VibroTest LX product. In case if you have any doubts, any clarifications, kindly contact us. Our email ID and phone numbers are given at the end. Please do contact us. Please also comment. If you have any points to know us, please do send us your points. Thank you very much.